What's up, guys? We're finally at Walt Disney World, where dreams come true. Look at Mickey on the right, Minnie on the left. Wow, I can't wait to see where our journey takes us. Looks like on the right you see Disney's Hollywood Studios. We're gonna check that out, of course. Looks like they aren't that busy today. It's Thursday, Epcot Center. Magic Kingdom, stay right here. This is Hollywood Studios. You stay on the right lane and check it out. This is Hollywood Studios. It's right on that exit, guys. Wow. The weather is really nice, warm and sunny, and I'm somewhat toasty. 79 degrees, I believe, today. So this is the warmest Christmas holiday that we've ever experienced since we're from St. Louis. Oh, what's the building in front? It looks like a... Oh my goodness, it's a roller coaster. I can see it. There's people suspended in the air and that... Wait, sorry, that's just a... that's just a replica of the Terror Tower, Tower of Terror. Wow. I thought this was a real thing. Twilight Zone. On the right side, I believe that's the hotel and resort. Look at that huge triangular building with that fish. What's up, guys? Today we're heading over to Epcot Center. First day at Disney World. Alright, so we are going to start off the day going to Epcot Center. It looks like the Magic Kingdom, the entrance of Magic Kingdom and the other more fun parts are super crowded with traffic. Let's go check out and see what the land is all about. More crowded in the mall.
Okay.
Right here. There's a crocodile!
In the desert, nature has created a very different, no less beautiful living system. And while this arid landscape may seem harmless, very much alive. Plants and animals that have learned to survive in these harsh conditions make use of what little water they can find and avoid the scorching rays of the burning sun. In the mountains, the mighty buffalo helped create the rich soil and one day become home to the American farm.
Oh, whoa, she got a house. Oops, this is crooked. It's like a haunted house.
Forces at work.
Hey.
Humans
have been
allowed in this cure. They need to produce food for the growing world. That's an enormous use. And sometimes overuse of money. In our search for more efficient ways to grow food, we often fail to realize the impact on that function.
In farmlands across America, we're learning that by plowing under vegetation containing natural fertilizers, we can enrich the soil without the use of chemicals. In Saudi Arabia and Mexico, we're learning to produce food on desert seacoasts by developing and planting crops that thrive on saltwater. Here at Epcot, we're learning to reduce the need for pesticides.
We are using tomorrow's energy and still restore the needs of the land. Some of the ants are being discovered.
We're outside.
And for your safety, please remain
safe.
Tropics are home to the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of these, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world.
Happy holidays!
These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions. Some, like the watermelon, thrive in wet, sloppy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy root of the plant has long been used to make flour for baking.
Hey,
this is
Look at the water down here. It's pretty.
When we mention farming,
fish.
Look at the fish. Tilapia. And right here, sturgeon. Whoa, look at how huge sturgeon. Hybrid crabs.
The sustainable system you're using here should suffer the water it contains. As a result, we're able to sustain billions of gallons each year.
Catfish breeding.
Our small fish farm produces nearly 5,000 pounds of fish each year to serve restaurants around Walt Disney World. Innovations like this have played an important role in our efforts to produce beyond our harvest and still protect our natural resources.
Look at the huge crab. Look at the huge shrimp. Buddha's hand. I've never seen a food like that. Sunflowers. We got lean cotton, fusion tea.
The common grains grown here include
millet, extremely hot pepper,
account for nearly two-thirds of our global
sage. Got people in the back.
I'm gonna say,
look at the Mickey Mouse ears. Look at the Mickey Mouse. You know what? Over here, we got
these
monkey,
plants are
tree,
definitely on their way up. Innovative growing techniques
Look at the huge watermelon of my parents.
Another innovation at work.
They've never grown anything that big, maybe half the size.
By populating our greenhouses with beneficial insects that prey on harmful pests, like we're significantly reducing our reliance on pesticides. We're growing using our nutrient film system. This technique precisely controls and recycles water and nutrients. We can produce over 27,000 heads of lettuce a year in this one small area.
We didn't make lettuce, huh? Green leaf lettuce, cucumber.
Some of our best ideas
zucchini,
have been inspired by nature, like these fruit and vegetable trees. By growing these groundnuts, we can increase yields.
Tomato vines.
These crops taste as good as they look. In fact, we save more than 13 tons of produce from our greenhouses and restaurants here at the land every year.
Look at how huge a pepper is! It's getting a little windy right now.
The future of agriculture may include innovative ideas like this vertical growing system.
There's a more space. You got some more tilapia right here.
By traditional growing
I think they use
that saves water and increases production. The aquaponics system on your left combines hydroponics with aquaculture. The fish provides a natural source of fertilizer for the plants, and the plants help keep the water clean for the fish. It's another great way to produce more while using less. In our lab, Epcot scientists are working with the U.S. Department of Agriculture on a number of innovative projects. The goal of these efforts is to produce higher-yielding and better-quality plants.
And this is it? Is this the right? Is that it?
We hope you've enjoyed this unique
experience. The ride, guys. On to the next one.
And check out the inside the boat and remain seated until the board comes to a complete stop.
If you guys enjoyed it, make sure you check out my next Disney World adventure. That's all. What we're gonna do next? Check out your concourse. Some kind of ride. Finally, after over an hour wait. So let's go check it out.
Yeah, we're together. What are you together?
10?
10.
We're at concourse C right now. If it's suspended in the air for an exhilarating gliding adventure that includes dramatic drops, turns, loops, and caution.
Go!
Section for me, please.
for takeoff.
Oh, wow.
Thank you.
time, every ride is going to be around 1 hour. Dean Higgins behind this door. What's up in here? No line lights. Can you believe it? Okay, sleepy guys.
This would be a great experience ever to win it again. But the most important thing that Tintoy did was plant in our heads the idea of
bigger than AMC.
And boats continue moving all the way across, filling every special seat. We hope you enjoy the rest of your day.
Conditioned rest area is like 81 degrees. It's perfect for just chill, eat some food. Test track right now. You see Universal Energy, Mission Space, Test Track, restrooms. We're over here at some restaurants right here. Let's go check it out.
Can you go ahead and back here? Companion, help you the hobby. Once I taught you all to live each living day,
test tracks presented by Chef Brian.
Wow, how's a bunch of like,
95 minute wait. Whoa, this is ridiculous. Check out around the world. It's like an international theme. You can tell from the distance, there's like a different landmarks, right? I see some Japanese buildings in the distance right there. That looks like more like a European theme, that's more like a Middle Eastern, Mexico right there. Alright, we're gonna check out this La Vida Antigua.
Oh, you should go. Yeah, that was it. Okay.
That's like.
No climbing. I know
we can do that. And it's funny because when I. I'm
gonna
find you a job for that.
It's so dark in here.
Okay.
It's like a party in there. Wow. It's like a city. There's no city in there. Tons of people. Look at this. This is crazy.
Yeah.
this Grand Fiesta tour.
All of a sudden, it was gone. Oh, my God.
More lines. At least it's not 95 minute wait. This is like Chinatown right here. Alright, we're gonna go check that out. This reminds me of like Chicago's Chinatown of interest. Inside, check it out.
I'm just trying to get through.
Thank you.
like an exact replica of a Hong Kong studio, movie studio. Oh, what's going on right there? Look at that. Earth moving. Oh, I know what's going on. It's going through the drawbridge. I'm getting video right now. Must be fireworks.
No, I didn't see that.
Oh, sorry.
You hurt my hand.
I definitely got in the way of this picture.
It's nice to me.
It's cute.
This is amazing.
I just said that out loud. I can't believe I just said that out
Even the night view is amazing. Whoa! Sushi place? No, it's like a bubble tea.
Scouting, Lucas, you want to get in with June?
Feels like Little Japan, don't you?
You
want
to get in with June?
Why, they don't care about
you.
We're
going to
save
this for like a nice one. It's a pretty drumstick. It's not flavored very well, but you know, the turkey you expect. It's pretty nice. Very meaty. I need my protein. It's not the best drumstick I ever had, but it's good enough. There you go, I'm going to try to finish it. That's like a Shinto Imperial Palace right there, like Call of Duty. Oh, this is exactly like Call of Duty. Going up to the palace, trying to overtake it. That's like a restaurant.
It reminds me of,
dinner. Now we're gonna walk down the rest of the international
scenery.
Oh, the scent of thousands of petals, they fill the air. All of the ladies, we are in pink organza. And one very lucky young lady, perhaps you is chosen Miss Roses. Would you come and take your aid? Let us give her a hand, please. If you would take your aid as the queen of the festival, can you hold for me? So you can imagine why her float, it too would be covered in pink roses, of course. And as she goes by, you would watch her as she waves to the crowd. Could you wave to your subjects? There she is, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Roses. Thank you, you did so good, I can take. Oh, that was good. You're on, ah, so good. So you see, the legend has it, there were two young lovers. Not yet for me. Good. Isleed, which means groom in Berber. Can you stand proud like the groom that you are? Ah, you are professional, I think, huh? Ah, and Tisleed, which means bride. Can you stand beautiful and delicate like the bride? Ah, she's good too. Now you see why the two young lovers, they wanted to marry, but up, 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 not so fast. You see, the parents were from enemy tribes. I'm watching. And they would not consent. Now the two lovers, why you are very playful. The two young lovers, they were so sad, they began to cry. Now I know you are a man, but I need you to cry. Hold your tears for me. And you hold your tears for me. Crying, sad, why are you smiling? You're sad. You too. You're crying, we're sad. So they cried like this until they're dead. Now, it is my legend, I must tell the thing. We tell your legend later. Okay, so they cried like this until their death. All thought love did lose, but once something wonderful happened, you see, the tears formed two lakes. They were Lake Isli and Lake Tisli, not far from Imilshiel. Well, the parents and the tribe were so moved to see the lakes, they decided from this moment on, their children should have the freedom to choose their own spouse. It has been this way ever since. You see, today, the festival of marriage in Imilshiel, it is still a big celebration when the two people, they come together to meet and find their lifelong partners. Good story, huh? Now we are, there we go. This is the legend of Imilshiel. I think good storytelling, you are hired. This is the way we like to share.
We are clapping, we are dancing, let's go, there we are. Ah, let's do the hip a little bit, just a little hip, huh? About the hand. Nice. We are going in a circle, here we go. Very good. Guess what? Let us wake the crowd up. We are going this way with a shimmy. Ah, that's good. How about the other way? Let's go the other way. Ah, this is so good. Let's take a bow for the dancing, huh? Clap for yourself and for my friend.
Jack.
Thank you.
That's an adventure size version of Pepperly.
Thank you. Tita.
I met this morning.
We asked him to enjoy this spaceship out before the fireworks. It's only 20 minute wait. Not too bad.
Over here?
Left?